just arrived at the Nexo headquarters in Pleilly near Paris, and first I will visit the production department. Please follow me. Bonjour, monsieur. Hello, Danny. Hi, I'm fine. I came to you to get some details about the production process. Can you give us a tour?
Yes, sure. But perhaps we, for the introduction, you should go outside because it's very noisy here and you will be much more comfortable.
Okay, I follow you. May I introduce you to Danny Baudier? He's working at Nexo for 23 years now and he will give us some interesting details about how to turn a pile of birch ply into a P12 loudspeaker. Danny, your turn.
Okay, so very interesting questions. Yeah, definitely production matter to us. So going in from a panel of wood and turning into a complete industry, yes, it's go through several different processes. The first process is obviously taking this large panel of wood and cutting them at the right dimension in order to have material ready for the CNC operations. CNC operation, what it is in two words here, yes, we have this blank parts of wood and we have to shape them in order to have the different parts to build the cabinet itself. It's a process that has been used at Nexo for many years and we were among the first to be equipped with this kind of technology. We are not the second generation of CNC machine because of the P12. Okay, P12, as you can see, is a rounded shaped cabinet. So the CNC operation have to go through a rounded shaped cabinet. So part of them are done on the first generation, but really the precise machining on this rounded shape is done through new generation of CNC machines.
But as far as I know, CNC works only for flat wood.
Yes, in fact, in the past, but now we have a three-dimensional CNC operation that are possible with new generation of CNC machine. And in case of the P12, we don't really have the choice because you can see the shape of this cabinet. It's a rounded shapes with quite a height that is consequent. So we need to make CNC operations on the three dimensions. So Nexo that was one of the pioneer with the CNC technology. Now is stepping to these new machines. We are doing real three dimension CNC operations. Next step obviously will be taking this prepared parts and put them together in order to build the ebenistry itself. And we are gluing them. It's an interesting process and that we use also for many years.
Wouldn't it be better to nail or to screw them?
We use screw in the past, but definitively gluing the different parts has many, many advantages in terms of productivity and quality. First, in fact, the contact surface between the different parts is much bigger than if you're using simple screws. So it means when you make some pulling tests, we have something that is four times stronger. Because gluing them is like soldering, you know. The glue will go into the wood, and when it's dry, in fact, it's like one piece of wood. So if you want to detach them, the wood will break. So for the longevity of the cabinet, it's a much better process. The other advantages also is also on the productivity because if you don't use screw, you don't make hole in the cabinet, so you don't have to hide the holes after that for the sanding process.
And after the gluing process, that P12 get painted.
Yes, but before you have to go to the sanding process because the quality of the painting is really depending on how you sand the cabinet. And for that also, Nexo, I've been pioneer investing, in fact, on sanding robots, which give a very, very constant quality to the cabinet. And as I mentioned, quality of the sanding will have consequences on the quality of the painting. Before painting, we make a very serious visual inspections because, as I mentioned, quality of the painting is really depending on the quality of the sanding. I want to mention also that for the P12, we are using a new paint. It's a much stronger materials that give a much more durability to the product, much more resistant to scratch, which is very important for the end user and the customers.
And what we have now is a finished cabinet. And now let's take a closer look at what happens next.
Sure.
Okay, now we've reached the assembly department. Danny, please explain us what is happening here exactly.
Okay, so we are reaching almost the latest processes, okay, in the productions. So now you have seen the wood workshop. We have the complete ebonistry, we have the different components, and we'll put all of them together. We test them, we pack them, and we ship them.
Okay. Can we take a closer look at the different stations?
Sure. So I think what you will notice is that, in fact, at Nexo, we lack modularity. So all the different workshop tables are on wheels. So we are capable to readjust the organization of the production depending on what we have on back orders or what is inside, in fact, the production forecast for the coming months. Give a lot of flexibility and a very short delivery time, lead time for the customers. Okay, so let's have a closer look to the assembly process. Lilian will be nice enough, in fact, to show us the different steps of building the complete cabinet now. Now he's installing, in fact, the absorber inside the cabinet. Let's go with the passive filter. So Lilian is about to install the handle. As you can see, in fact, the P12 includes a speak-on connector inside the handle, which is used for monitor application and makes, in fact, something very clean and very neat on stage with not a lot of cabling. So you can make something very clean with this possibility. So now you will install the vent. Okay, we are using this special glue that will avoid the cabining having any air leaking. And you will install the coaxial driver. We are close to the end. So now Lilian will install, in fact, the HF horn. The grill is ready to be mounted. Fix the safety cable. The quarter turn lock. Okay. Okay, so now it's almost finished. Huh? Thank you very much, Lilian, for this nice demonstrations, and now we'll go for testing and then for packing.
Okay, off we go. Okay, and what is happening here?
So now we are testing the box one by one. Then I will attach also the RFID numbers to the serial number, because if the test is passed, we'll generate, in fact, the serial number of the cabinet. So it means that if the test fails, there is no any possibility of customer receiving a box that have a failed test.
The RFID chip, which function exactly does this one have?
Yes, in fact, inside the cabinet you have a unique RFID number that, in fact, tracing the cabinet from first process of the production to the end. And now we are reaching the end of the production, because we will initiate, we will generate the serial number. So, in fact, the software will attach the RFID number to the serial number to record, in fact, all the different process and all the wood, which batch of wood had been used, which condenser have been used for the... So we have a full traceability of the products by doing that. So if a customer faces any problem outside, for example, with a condenser, we know exactly which batch of condenser is involved, and we can have a proactive action with the other customers that receive cabinet with the same condenser. Okay, so now we will test the first cabinet. The position of the box has to be very precise. Okay. Okay, I think we are ready for the test. Okay, so just with just one swipe, we are measuring polarity, phase, frequency response, and distortions. And now Willy is checking on the screen that the box is okay. Did he succeed? Yes. Okay, so the test succeeds. So now the cabinet, we will generate the serial number of the cabinet. This serial number will be attached to the physical RFID number of the box, okay? And then we will be capable to pack the box, print the stickers, and ship to customers.
Danny, that was very interesting. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Thank you very much.
And I will continue now to the R&D department.